Have you ever wanted to direct your employees? Well, yeah, no, but that's not what this is about. This is about having an employee directory within Softr. The value of an employee directory is pretty huge. An employee directory is an internal tool for managing your company and employee information in a centralized way. New employees can benefit from them during the onboarding process to get a deeper understanding of the company. And existing employees can use this to find information on a specific colleague and get in touch, or simply to get to know them better. In some directories, employees can also submit requests for time off and expenses. Managers can update the profiles of employees or contractors and track all of the requests as well. You can install this template very easily by going to softr.io in the template section and using the link down below. You can press use template and then add this to a data source and add it very quickly to your Softr system. I'm going to use an API key for Airtable and then copy it to my account. And then after adding the base into Airtable, you can see that here are the different aspects that we have in here. We have an employee directory, so all of our team members, the departments that they're in, and then a section for employee time off and expenses. Then once we press create application, that Airtable base information is gonna jump right into our Softr app. We can test this out right away by pressing publish and then going it to the new tab, and provided in there is gonna be two different magic links to users in the app. One being Pat the manager and Jen an employee. Managers in this template can submit expenses, book time off, and search in the directory, as well as add to the directory, unlike the employees who are not able to add to this. Anyone can also go into their account section here and update their information, change their name, not their email, but their avatar image and their password as well. When taking a look at Dan's link, who is the employee, however, you can see that I no longer am able to add anyone like I could with the manager, Pat. As you can see, if I press add here, this would, for example, if I added myself, if I add Dimitri Panici, I'm in New York, I can add a photo of myself right here, and then job title, video guy. And then in the department, I could pick marketing and then add. And look at that, I'm added to the employee directory. And you can see the use case of this, right? Because then once I were to go into, you know, another coworker's section, this would showcase when they started, the person's position, email, location, and a bunch of other information about them, including contact information and bio. And I can quickly and easily go back to the employee directory by clicking right here. Now, an employee can see all that information and still sort through, you know, for example, the marketing department can sort, for example, through things like the executive or engineering department, and then as well as the location. As you can see, Geronimo is in New York, and I can still go and see this information, but I just can't necessarily add anything. But what I can do is, in both circumstances, see the org chart. Then for both people, they're also able to submit expenses. So the way that this works is when I click here, I have the option to pick between different expense types. And just like any other form within Softr, if I go to the submit expenses section, you can see that this is sending it to the data source and sending it to the various fields within my Airtable, but there's also two hidden fields. So this makes sure that the hidden fields map to the proper people. So when it comes to the forms here, we have email so that the employee who is submitting it, it'll track to their email. And then the employee will map correctly to that record ID as well, because we don't want them forgetting who submitted it. And then it comes down to a whole issue. So all we need to do here is essentially say, all right, home office, I purchased a new HDMI cable for a monitor. And you would upload the receipt or invoice. And then let's say it costs $15 for an HDMI cable. And the purchase date was yesterday. And I'm just going to put a dummy image here because I don't have a real invoice, and then press submit expense. Now, I would recommend you actually put invoices and stuff, because it's not legal advice or accounting advice, but maybe leaving it empty would be bad idea. If we go into Airtable, we can now see that Pat submitted that HDMI cable expense in here, and that they've submitted a lot of expenses Maybe we should check in on what's going on with this. It's a pretty big one. But in all seriousness, all of these do work similarly. So the employee details that I dropped in earlier for Dimitri can be adjusted to add more fields here. So say, for example, those details that you see on an individual person's page, you know, maybe I wanted to see more than just basic information put in. What I can do is I can adjust the different fields that are added within this record. And if I wanted to also add an update button, I can do the same by adding a new item button or something like edit, records, and then within the employee details section, say you wanted to have the option to update this as well from within here, we could very simply add an action button for editing the record and then assigning the different fields that you'd want. As you can see, it already grabbed everything within here. So if I were to publish this, after having mapped all of these different fields, I could go into the detail field and then update it rather than needing to adjust it in Airtable. Now, very similarly to the submit expenses, there is a book time off option with multiple hidden fields as well. In the same way, if we go into the template, we can make sure that we're tracking people's time off and there's no confusion on who is submitting it because there's multiple hidden fields that once again map to the employee and their record ID as well as their employee email. And what I would recommend that you do is set off the different items here to required. So it has them forcibly say what the time off type is for, whether it's sick leave or vacation, what the reason is, and then the start date so that we make sure we get all the information out of them for what necessarily the time off is being taken for. So when we're going in here, we would pick from these different items. And then for example, say vacation, I'm going to the beach and the time off start date could be in the future coming weeks, and then request time off would get submitted into our data source. Another great thing that you can do here is if I typed out softr.io, I can make it so that only people with that domain can sign up to this app. So say I were to open it in a new tab and I wanted to sign up, all I need to do is put in my information with an email that's at softr.io, put a password, agree to terms, sign up. And as you can see, I've already done this, but it allows you to do it because if I change this to .io, emails with that domain would not be allowed. So this is an awesome system for you to see the different people in your company, submit time off, manage expenses, and just get to know your coworkers a little bit better. Just like you got to know Softr a little bit better in this video and this one as well. Thanks for watching and we'll see you in the next one.